Regular viewers to this channel have seen me install switches, receptacles, and usually when we go to make that connection, I'll say, you know, just turn the fastener until it's really snug. Don't give you a value, didn't know what the value was. Turns out there are values. For example, on this product right here, which is a 1450 receptacle, it says that there's a 20 inch pound setting for torque for the fasteners on it. For receptacles and switches, it's 14 to 18 inch pounds. For this 20 amp circuit, it is 27 inch pounds for each of those fasteners. Why is torque important? Well, because when you make a connection and you tighten it down, if the torque is not correct, this wire is heating up and cooling off. It's expanding and contracting every time it gets used. And if the torque is insufficient, too loose, then over time, this wire might start to loosen up and could start arcing. Or in the case of this circuit breaker, it could potentially slip out, all of which can cause a problem. So we don't want that. If you over-tighten, you could damage the internals of the device. You could pinch the wire so hard that it might fail in the future. So again, the correct torque is very important. To achieve a specified torque level, you need a torque wrench of some sort. Most wrenches like this are for foot-pounds. They're basically automotive type applications. For electronics, you want inch-pounds. This one happens to be inch-pounds. It's from Harbor Freight. It's under 20 bucks. The only thing I don't like about this particular torque wrench is that when it achieves its correct setting, it barely makes the noise. So I don't like that. I want to hear a positive click to let me know that I've attained the correct torque, and this tool doesn't. This led me on a search for a torque screwdriver. They're kind of expensive. They are upwards of $200, $300, the really good ones. But in searching, I did come up with this unit. Vortex Optics Torque Wrench Mounting Kit. I know, it looks like a torquing screwdriver, and it is. And although this looks exactly like the Capri torque screwdriver, the big difference between this and that one is that Vortex Optics warranties this product for life, regardless of what causes a problem. It lists for $150. I got mine for 80 something on Amazon. It goes from 10 to 50 inch pounds, which is perfect for this type of application. Looking on the back side, we see that it includes 5 hex bits, 3 torque bits, 1 screwdriver bit, 1 socket, and 1 socket adapter. Comes in a tube. You just twist it apart. You can hang it from the top, like on a pegboard or something. There's a cap here to keep the driver from moving around. We pull it out. We have our bits, adapters, in a plastic pouch. Instruction sheet, certification of calibration, which at this price range, not all tools include that. And then the actual driver features on the tool. It has a comfortable rubber grip handle. The back of it has an opening for a 1/4 inch adapter. Then up front, there's your numeric scale from 0 through 9. Above that is the inch pound scale. And then you have a collar. And to make an adjustment, all you need to do is you pull down on the collar and you turn the handle. So right now we're at 13 inch pounds. So you can go all the way up to 50 by simply turning the handle and releasing the collar. You can pick any setting that works for you. The top, where the bit goes, has a spring bearing. So what you do is you set in your bit, and then you push it in, and it snaps in. So now it's not going to drop out on you. So it's almost as good as magnetic. Makes it a little bit of a challenge sometimes to get them out, but it's nice because it is spring tensioned. So not a very complex tool to operate. And when you're done, you just make sure that you set it back to 10 pounds, which is best for the internal mechanism to operate with. So let's try setting this to 14 inch pounds and setting our torque on the receptacle. The only thing I don't like about this kit is that these are designed for optics because that's what they sell. So they're kind of for like gun optics. So most of these really won't be all that useful to connecting electrical devices. But if you have some of these laying around somewhere, then you are in business. I just take one of those, drop it in. It's locked in. We are set at 14. We come over to our receptacle here. And we work the screw down. Let's see what happens when we start torquing. You see what happens with the handle? It's turning because we have reached 14 pounds, and so it releases. And so now we know that this is a good, solid, properly set, torqued connection. For the circuit breaker, we need 27 inch pounds. So we're at 20, and we go to 27, release the collar, and it locks in place, 27. And then we come to our circuit breaker, insert the blade. You want to be straight as possible onto that fastener to get the most accurate torquing. And this is a very soft metal that they're using on this fastener. So too bad it's not a ratcheting. And the blade is we're scraping off a little bit of the fastener with the blade. Let's see if I can find a blade that'll go in, sit in a little deeper than what we have now. That should do it. Again, we put our bit in, push it all the way till it snaps. Now it's being held in place. This drops into the fastener. We turn. Okay, that's 27. The handle turned, the blade stayed in place. That's a lot of torque. I wouldn't have known that had I tried it by hand. So, but that's what this device requires to hold that wire in place, regardless of how many times it heats up and cools down, and that expansion and contraction, so that you have a connection that should last the lifetime of the device. While the handle is rubber coated, this tool is not electrically insulated. So when working with electrical devices, make sure the power is off. When done, simply remove your bit, store it, press the collar, turn the handle, and bring this back down to 10 inch pounds, I should say, right there. And that's the resting spot for the internal mechanism. Things that I don't like about this tool, well, just the fact that these accessories probably won't come in very handy when you're working with receptacles and outlets and any electronic devices, because that's not really what they're meant for. They're meant for opticals. But you can pick up one of these relatively inexpensive to get you to where you have your Phillips, your straights, and your squares. So other than that, oh, and the fact that these are just loose, there's no container. It's not like you can throw them in the back of the handle. But again, in our situation, we're really not going to miss these because they don't have that much of an application for electrical work. Other than that, I think this is great. Like I said, for under $100, $150 retail, closer to $80-something at Amazon, I think this Vortex branded torque screwdriver, torque wrench kit, as they call it, is a great accessory to have if you're doing any type of electrical work. If you found this video interesting or useful, give us a thumbs up, leave us a comment, join the subscription team, and as always, thank you ever so much for watching.